Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Oh my god, I have to stop doing that. Okay. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. For today's video, I wanted to do a tutorial on the dip powder system. The system itself has been around for a while. I actually have this set here that I bought about a year and a half ago. And it is from Color Club, and it's called Serendipity. So I've been using those for about a year and a half. I really like them. I can grow my nails naturally. I don't know if you can see, but hopefully you can see them. The problem is keeping them long. One of them will break, as you can see here. This one's kind of shorter than the rest of them, but whatever, we're just gonna use it for today anyways. But yes, so I can grow my nails. The problem is keeping them long, because individually they'll snap one by one, or they get like a little tear and you end up peeling them off, or whatever the case may be. So I saw these about a year and a half ago, and I think it was Marshall's or Winners or something like that, and I grabbed them. I think the kit was about $12.99. I really like them. For me personally, I work every day, I use my hands every day at work. I do dishes, I clean the house all the time, all the regular stuff that you do when you have a family. And they usually last on my nails about anywhere from 2 to 3 weeks. So, and usually then it's just either a little bit of chipping, or what happens is my nail will start to grow in and you get like the gap down there. So I'll usually just clean it off and start again. However, I have this new set that I got at Showcase, and it is called Rosynail. I've never tried this set before. It's a new, I believe, to Showcase. So it is a dip nail set. Now, what I want to do with this particular set after I do my nails is I want to see if A, how long it'll last, and B, if it does last long enough for, if it does last long enough for my nails to grow in, I want to see if I can maybe just go in and just kind of fill it in and see how that will end up looking, and if it looks okay, or if that is actually possible to do with the product or not. I'm not sure. I've never tried that yet. Like I said, I usually just clean it off and then start again. Another thing I want to try doing is I want to make an accent nail, but I want to use the sparkles that I picked up yesterday, and I will be doing it with the sponge technique that I've showed you in my previous nail videos. Alright, so I'm just going to show you the system itself here real quick. So this is the actual system. It's called Rosynails. And in the set, you get a prep, you get a base coat, a activator, and a top coat. The colors that come with it are kind of like a white sparkly sort of color. I don't know if you can tell on camera, but that kind of has like a bit of sparkle to it. And then there's kind of like a salmony light pink. And then the next two colors are the ones that I'll be using on my nails, which is a gray kind of beigey color. And then another pink, but it's just a little darker than the first pink. So now, having previously used these kits before, there are some things that they don't really mention in the directions that I would definitely recommend using when you do use these kits and to just have ready. One of those things is definitely two small brushes, and I will show you why when I get to doing the actual dipping and everything. But you're going to find that some of the powder is going to get around the outside of your nail, and it's just a lot easier if you have a little brush. To record by a window and not having a proper microphone. Oh my god, hurry up, go away. Alright, so anyways, you may end up getting some of the powder around, or you're going to end up getting some of the powder around your finger. So if you have a little brush handy, you can just use it to kind of knock off some of the powder that gets left around the nail, because once you put the activator on, it's going to get very hard, and then you can't just wipe it off. Which is why another thing that I recommend having handy when you do this is a very, very strong nail file and a very, very coarse nail file, which is what I have here, as well as some just regular nail files. And then I have my sponges again for when I do my sparkles. I'm just gonna zoom the camera in so that you can get a better view of what I'm doing. And I'm just gonna kind of walk you through the steps of how I use the kit and how I do my nails with the dip nail, and also how I'm going to make my accent nail. Alright, so I'm going to zoom the camera in so you guys can get a better view. And then we shall start. So, on this particular box that I got at Showcase, they don't really give you very much instructions, which is kind of a running theme that I find with Showcase products. They don't usually come with a lot of directions. So I'm going to try to remember to include all the tips and tricks that I have learned over the last year and a half of using this stuff, such as using the little brushes. So the first thing I would suggest is making sure that your nails are all cleaned and prepped. Your cuticles should be pushed back. Anything that you would normally do to prep your nails before you put nail color on it. Also, I'm gonna recommend that you just kinda buff up the top of your nails a little bit. It just helps to give the whole product something to adhere to. So that's what I'm gonna do real quickly right now. And I'm just lightly buffing it. I don't wanna destroy the top of my nail or anything. I just kinda wanna give it a bit of a rougher surface for the dip to stick to. And you want to make sure that you have your nails shaped and everything as well before you do your dip. It is going to make your nails very hard, so you definitely want to make sure that you file your nails to the shapes that you want before you dip your nails. So after you've done that, you just want to go in and wash any residue or any of the file remnants that may be left on your nails. You just want to make sure you go and wash those off. The first thing that we're going to start with is our prep. And we're going to do each nail in a coat of prep. I'm going to actually recommend that you also loosen these lids before you start, because you don't want to start dipping your nails and then mess them up trying to open up your lids afterwards. So maybe have those cracked and ready to go. Right, so I'm just gonna apply the prep to my nails. I'm just gonna give that a couple of seconds to dry. All right, that actually dried like super, super quick. So the next thing that I'm going to recommend, which I actually forgot, thing to cover your surface when you dip your nails, because it does make a little bit of a mess, so you don't wanna just drop it all over your table. So I would recommend laying down something. I'm just gonna open up my powders and get them ready. Wow, you do get a whole bunch of product in here. Like, that's a lot. That other kit that I showed you is pretty much still full, and like I said, I've been using it for a year and a half. This will last, oh gosh. I'd say it should last you at least a year. Even if you were to use it like every 3 weeks, like that's a lot. And as I do my nails, you'll see like it does not take a lot to do your actual nails. So you wanna get your powders ready. And I'm actually gonna rotate my colors a little bit just because, again, I want to try and do the accent nail with the sparkles. So how I'm actually going to do mine is I'm going to do gray or beige, whichever color you want to call it. I'm just going to say gray for the sake of the video because it looks kind of grayish to me. And I'm not sure if when it's activated, if it's going to go maybe a beige-ish. It looks like it may go kind of a beige color. So I'm just going to say gray for now. So I'm going to do gray, pink, gray, and then the pink here. And then this is the one that I'm going to add the sparkle to. So I'm just going to go ahead and start dipping and show you guys the process. The first thing that you're going to apply before you even dip your nail is your base coat. And again, you want to be very careful when you apply this not to go too far around your finger. You want to really make sure that you get around the edges, but you don't want to get around your finger. But if you do, it's okay, because you're going to have your little brush to kind of clean around your edges, which I will show you after I'm done dipping mine. You don't need a whole bunch of this stuff. You just need a very light coat, a very light coating of it. Oh, wow, you get a lot on this brush. Holy moly. Ooh, yeah, you don't need quite that much. Ooh, wow. Now this stuff here is actually, it's almost like a glue. So you're basically just applying a glue to your nail before you're dipping it so the dip has something to stick to. Again, you want to make sure that you get all the edges, especially make sure that you get out to the very tip of your nail. And then we're just going to dip it. And the way I like to do it is I just stick my finger in, but I kind of scoop up as I'm bringing it out, just to get as much on there as possible. Hopefully you guys can see that. And then I just tip it back off into the container. Okay. Now, as you can see, it went a little wonky here. I don't know what happened, but I got a bit of a lump there. So I'm just gonna take my little brush. Hopefully you guys can see this. I'm just gonna kinda, okay, you know what? That's gone hard already, so I can't really fix that. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take off all the excess around it. And I'm gonna show you, if you do make a mistake like this where you get a little, if you do make a mistake like this where you get a little bit too much on it, I'm gonna show you what you can do to fix it. And we're gonna dip it again, so you don't have to worry about how messy the first dipping is. It's not gonna look that great, but we're gonna do it again. This is why I recommended having the really strong file. If you do happen to make a mistake like I did, how I have this big lump here, you can just kind of take your file and just file it down. Alright, it's a little awkward for me to do this because I'm actually left-handed, so. Alright, I just want to get this big lump off here. Alright, I'm just going to smooth it out. As you can see, it's starting to get a little bit smoother. I really hope my camera's focusing on this. So as you can see, it's getting a little bit smoother. I'm just gonna keep filing it until it's all gone. Until it's as flat as I want it to be. This is very difficult to do on camera. It's much easier to do when you're just sitting and doing it by yourself. Alright, so you can feel it until you get it to the smoothness that you want it to be. And so also, before you go to dip for a second time, like I was saying, it doesn't matter how much really that you try to keep it clean, you are going to get some on the sides. So this is where this comes in handy too. You can use it to kind of clean around the edges. And I like to do that before I dip it again. Otherwise, it's going to get very, very hard and it'll be harder to remove. So I'm just going to file off any extra chunks that are, have gotten stuck in my skin. Another thing I'm going to recommend is having maybe something around that you can use to get under your nail in case any of the powder gets under there. You can kind of use it to get some of it out. I just use my little scissors. I wouldn't recommend using something this sharp. I use them all the time, so I'm comfortable. I'm used to them. But if this is your first time doing it, I definitely would not recommend something this sharp. Maybe just a regular nail cleaner or a nail file, like the little metal nail files. That's all I have, so that's what I'm using. Alright, so I'm just getting any extra off the edges here, as you can see. Alright, and then I'm going to get ready to dip it again. And we're going to add our base coat again. Which again, is basically just glue. I get it very even this time. Take off any excess that may be on there. I don't want it super thick. Alright. And again, I'm just going to dip it in. Very, very gently. upwards motion. So as you can see, it's just like a little pile sitting on top of my nail. And again, I'm not concerned with how much is coming off over the edge, because we have this piece of paper, we can just fold it up and pour it all back in again. And then I'm just gonna tap, tap, tap the extra off. Okay, and as you can see, the second coat is much, much smoother. It looks much better, there's more color. And now is where I wanna really make sure that I get in precise and clean it before I put the activator on it. So again, take my little brush on the side here. Some of it has gone over the edges, but again, that's why we have the file. We can take that off later. I'm just gonna slightly clean up around here. All right. And the next step is we're going to add our activator. I would recommend doing this as well, one nail at a time, just because you don't want to accidentally knock some of the powder off as you're doing your other nails or anything like that. So it's easier just to activate it, set it, and do it all at the same time. You do want to be fairly generous with the activator, because remember, this is what's going to harden it and make it really strong on your nails. So we just apply that. Now, it does have a bit of a smell to it, so if you are affected by smells or anything like that, I would recommend doing it by an open window or something like that, somewhere where you have ventilation. So again, if we don't want to waste this stuff, we can just take our paper and we're just going to fold it up like so. And then we're just going to pour the rest of it back into the container. That's it. So, as I was saying, a little bit of this stuff should go a very, very, very long way. Now, it doesn't take long for this stuff to dry. It doesn't say in the directions how long it's going to take to dry, but mine is like pretty much dry already, and it's been about, I don't know, just since I've been sitting here talking. So, yeah. So, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to apply the top coat. Wow, that is seriously thick top coat. Whoo, look at that. All right, so what I'm thinking is at this stage for my accent nail, so right after I activate it is when I'm going to try to apply the sparkles to it on this nail, and then I will apply the top coat to it. But for the rest of my nails, I will be following the exact same process that I'm doing now. Only the accent nail that I'm going to be doing different. Wow, this stuff's very, very thick. In my other kit, it's not this thick. This stuff is like super thick. Okay, you do not want to use a lot of this. Very little amounts of the top coat. It's very sticky. Wow, okay. Just trying to get a little bit of it off because it's very, very thick. I didn't realize how much I was using. So yes, when you do, if you do decide to use this kit and you're doing it at home, be very, very careful that you do not use too much of this top coat. It's very, very thick. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and let that dry and I will let you know how long that takes. And when this is completely dry, I will come back, I will let you know how long it took, and I'm going to do the rest of my nails. So now for me, because I have experience with this product, for the most part, I'm just gonna dip all my nails once and then do the rest of the things. But if you are doing this for your first time, I would highly recommend one nail at a time, like I showed you with this nail. So my nails are done. This is the final result. Ignore the mess on the bottom of my hands here. As you can see, the jar, the lid came off, and I had to use it like this, which, I mean, not really too impressed with that. I don't know why that happened or how that happened, or I don't know. I will start off by saying, not just this product, I mean, not just this brand, but the dip stuff in general is very, very messy. So you definitely want to lay something underneath your hands that you can just pick up and kind of pour the stuff in the garbage or pour it back in the container, because it is going to make a huge mess, which again, it doesn't matter the brand, it's going to happen with any kind of brand. It has a very, very, very strong smell that is not true of every brand. The other brand that I have does not have such a strong smell, so if you are going to use this stuff, definitely make sure that you are in a well-ventilated area. If you have anybody in your house that has respiratory issues, maybe do this in a completely separate room or outside, but do not do it around them. It's a very strong smell. It does take a lot of practice. If it's your first time doing it and you know it looks a little crappy and it's a little messy and whatever, it's fine. Don't be hard on yourself. I've been using this stuff probably, this is probably my fifth or sixth time using it, and again, my job isn't even perfect. Like, I had to file a lot and I had to fix it, and it's still not absolutely perfect, but again, it takes a lot of practice. So keep that in mind. Another thing that I really don't like, and I don't know what it is with this company and why they've chosen to do it this way. It's very strange to me, because again, my other kid isn't like this. For one, it comes with four bottles, whereas my other kid only came with three. So, which is the base prep, which is like a bond for the powder stuff, and then you have your activator stuff, and then you have a top coat. This stuff had like the prep and then a base coat, which the base coat is kind of like a glue, which my other one is kind of like a glue, but it's not as thick. I don't know why this stuff is so thick. So when you do go to use the base coat, very sparingly. Very, very thin amounts, or else you're gonna end up with crap glopped all over your nail, which I did for my very first nail because I didn't realize that it was so thick, because like I said, my other one isn't like that. So keep that in mind. The top coat, I don't know why they chose to do it this way, but it's almost the exact same as the base coat. It's like a very, very thick glue, which is very weird to me. Usually a top coat is just like a very thin clear nail polish, right? Like, I mean, I don't understand why they made this as thick as it is, and I don't even know if I can open it because, again, the lid fell off. Oh, look at that. The lid, I guess, fixed itself. Okay. Anyways. But, yeah, you can see, like, it's very, I don't feel that it's very good for a top coat. I mean, it does dry very hard, but so do my other ones in the top coat. I'll show you the top coat for my other one, actually. This, and it's called the finishing gloss, and as you can see, like, it's nowhere near like that. This is very, very thin, so I don't know why they chose to do that. So overall, I'm gonna say out of five, I'm gonna say, as an experienced dip user, I'm gonna have to say a 2 out of 5, just because I don't like that top coat, I don't really like the base coat, and I don't really understand the purpose of the prep. I have no idea why they want you to do that. Other than that, though, I like the colors. The powder texture was okay. It was almost, my other one I find is a little more finely milled, but that's okay. It didn't really affect the way to apply it or anything. I'm trying to get all this glue off the bottom of my hands because that stupid thing exploded on me. But anyways, so yeah, I would use it again now that I know to use a lot of the bottled stuff very, very sparingly. I will definitely give it another shot like that. But I mean, overall, I kind of like my other brand better. So yeah, it is what it is, I guess. Hi guys, so I look a mess, my hair's a mess, I don't have makeup on, whatever, I'm not worried about that right now. This is just a kind of edit for my nail video. I just wanted to catch you up on how the process is going. I did my nails 3 days ago, and I was actually cleaning today, and as you'll notice, The dip that was on my nail actually popped right off, which I've never had happen before. I found that very strange. Now, I'm thinking what may have caused it was this prep. As I said, with my other kit, it didn't come with a prepping step. It just comes with the bonding, which you put on and then you dip, and then you put on your activator and then you put on your top coat. So I don't know if maybe the prep, if it makes it easier to take the actual dip off of your nail. If that is the case, then I will say that this is definitely a great kit for a beginner. If you're looking for something, or if you've used a kit a few times and you're looking for something that's going to last up to a couple months, I don't know if this is the kit for you. I am going to experiment with it a little bit more. I'm going to see if I can pop the rest of these off just as easy or not. I'm going to leave my accent nails on, and the reason being is I only dip my accent nails once, whereas the rest of my nails I did twice. So maybe the fact that I did it twice made it a little harder and easier for it to separate from my nail. I don't know, so I'm going to try and figure that out. So yeah, I'm going to go through, I'm going to get them off. Hopefully I can just pop them all off and not have to go through the lengthy process of removing them. Which again is why I would say that this would be good for a beginner, because with my other kit, it's quite a lengthy process to remove it, and I will get into that later. But for right now, yes, the fact that they just pop off would make it very great for a beginner's kit or somebody who's just trying the product out for the first time. So I'm just going to zoom my camera in here, and then I'm going to show you if these will pop off or how I can remove them, and then I'm going to go through and I'm going to dip them again, but I'm just going to do it once this time. Again, I have my little brushes and my nail files and stuff. So, oh, and a little disclaimer, I am using this metal nail file to try and pop them off. I would not recommend this if you haven't done dip nails, or I wouldn't recommend doing this at all with fake nails, anything, but again, I've done these a few times. I have done it this way before. I am experienced with it, so I feel comfortable doing it this way, and that's why I'm going to do it this way. But you can do a lot of damage with your nails. If it doesn't separate easily and you just rip it off, you are going to destroy your nails. So yes, I would not recommend using this or anything. Do it the proper way, soaking and everything, which again, I will get into at the end. But yes, I'm doing it this way because I've done it before and I am comfortable doing it. All right, so as I said, I'm just going to go around and try to pop these all off. So the only place it's really, really sticking to is the tip of my nail, and I don't want to break my nail off, so I have to be very, very gentle, and I may actually just end up going in and trying to put in some acetone under there or some nail polish remover. And it's sticking to the tip of my nail. It's easy to get the part that's on my actual nail here up, but once it gets to the tip, that's where it's really sticking. So I'm not really sure why my index came off quite as easy. Because these ones aren't coming off as easy. So as you can see, it's not actually coming up as easy as I hoped it would. All right, I'm gonna move on to my other hand. All right, this one's not budging at all. All right, so I may actually end up having to show you the whole removal process. This is the one that came off super easy on this side. It just popped right off. This one seems to be stuck on better. I don't really know why that one came off so easy. I did get them a little bit loosened, but none of them actually fully came right off. But as you can see, it's starting to lift off a little bit. So I am gonna have to go in with a bit of nail polish remover. So because I have done this before, I know that you need a very, very strong nail polish remover. I had like a Sally Hansen from the dollar store that I was using before, and it just was not cutting it. It took forever to get it off. So I actually went and got this OPI stuff. It's supposed to be for removing gel nails. So I'm hoping that this will help to remove it a lot easier. So for the ones that are already loosened and starting to come up like this one, I'm gonna try and see if I can just get the acetone down underneath the nail to get the rest of it to lift off. I'm just using a Q-tip and trying to kind of get in under it. Basically just kind of trying to pour it down inside behind the nail. Let's see if I can just kind of loosen it a little bit more. All right, it is starting to kind of break up and come off a bit easier. There we go. See how that just popped off? I do have some that's really stuck on here, so I'm gonna leave that for now and just try to get as much off as I can by just kind of pouring the polish down inside. Hopefully you guys can see this. Just trying to get it up under between my nail and the actual dip. Sit in there for a bit and break it down a little bit. I'm gonna try to go back in with my tool and see if it's loosened it at all. Again, it is starting to break it down a little bit. It's still stuck on my tip though, so I'm gonna just keep adding some more polish to it, or some more remover to it. Kind of lift it up and get the polish worked in there. Or the remover, sorry. Trying to get the remover worked in there. And you can see it's starting to lift up a little bit more. Again, I'm just gonna go in, loosen some of it up. It's still really stuck on the tip of my nail, so again, I'm just gonna keep going in and doing the same process and adding the polish behind the nail. This one really doesn't want to let go. All right, so again, it's just my tip that it's stuck on, and I really don't want to break the tip of my nail. So I'm gonna go back in with some more polish. So as you can see now, the Q-tip is actually going right under, and I can kind of get at right the tip of my nail. So I'm just breaking it down slowly with the nail polish remover. I'm actually going to go ahead and stick my whole finger in the remover. See if that helps. Oh, this stuff is really stuck, man. Okay, look at that. I got it. Except for this one little stubborn piece here, but whatever. We'll deal with that after. We got that piece off. All right. I'm gonna do the thumb last because it's not really coming up very much, so I'm gonna have to do a lot of work with that, and I will show you how that is done. First, I'm gonna just get these other ones off. I'm gonna do it the same way that I've been doing it. Except I'm just gonna soak my whole finger in the container because that seems to be easier. If you have any small cuts on your finger or anything, I would not recommend soaking it in the acetone. What I would actually do is maybe pour some on a piece of paper towel and then just wrap around your finger and let it sit on there maybe. Or just, again, use the Q-tip and just get in behind it like I was before. So we're really just left with the most stubborn pieces, but I will show you how to deal with those after. This one is not gonna budge either. We're gonna have to go through the whole process of doing this how you would normally do it. So, get that out of the way so I don't spill it. All right, I will start on this little pinky nail here. So what you are actually supposed to do is file it down because we put the top coat on it. So you have to file it down to break off all that top coat. So that's what I'm gonna do now. You're gonna want a very strong, very coarse file for this. So first I'm just gonna go and file off all the top coat on it, on all of the nails. You will start to feel that it's not quite as smooth anymore, and you can actually feel some of the powder starting to break off. Now mine is gonna be a bit harder to remove because I did do two coats. So again, if you're doing this as a first time, you might just want to dip it once and be done. It will be easier to remove. As you can see, my thumb still has the top coat completely intact. It's still very shiny. So I'm just going to show you the difference between that and after I file it. Here's the difference between it after it has been filed. You can see it's no longer shiny. It's more of a matte finish now. Okay, so I'm just gonna go ahead and do my other hand. So the proper way that they're going to tell you in the directions, and probably in other videos if you watch them, the proper way they're gonna tell you to remove it is you're supposed to soak a piece of cotton or paper towel and just wrap it around the nail. And you are supposed to wrap it in tin foil. I don't have tin foil around me right now, so I'm not gonna bother with that. And normally, like I said, because I've used these before and I've also been doing my nails themselves for a very long time, I would normally just dip it right into the nail polish. But for the sake of showing you guys, this is what you do. You just leave it sitting there, and they want you to leave it they usually recommend about 5 minutes, I think it is, but whenever I have done it this way, it's taken me anywhere from about 20 minutes to an hour for it to soak in. But again, I usually use a lot cheaper nail polish remover. So I'm hoping that this stuff will maybe help to remove it a little faster. So I'm just going to let it sit and I'm going to let it soak for a bit. I will come back and I will let you know how long I let it soak for and I will let you see the results. Alright, so I've had it sitting here soaking for about 2 minutes. And this is really about all that's happened is, as you can see, it's starting to break it down a little bit at a time, coat by coat. This way is fine if you have a lot of patience and you just want to sit and let it dissolve itself away, then that's fine. But for me, I don't know, I don't really like doing it this way. I find it takes a long time and I just don't like it. So I'm going to do it my way. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to take my file and I'm going to file off as much of this stuff as I can get off my nails, and then I'm going to finish it off with the nail polish. So I'm just going to go ahead, I'm going to finish filing as much as I can off of camera, and I will be back. Alright, so I got it all off of my nails. It took me about an hour. I soaked each finger individually in the nail polish remover, and then I just picked it off piece by piece. So now technically I could have just re-dipped the nail that came off. However, I wanted to show you guys a couple different ways that you can remove it as well. So again, I'm just gonna go in and re-dip these ones. However, I'm just gonna do one coat this time, which is another thing that I would definitely recommend for beginners. If you're gonna do it, just do one coat for your first try. It's much easier to get off with one coat. So again, we're just starting off with the prep. So I'm gonna start off with my gray again, just for these three fingers, and then I'm gonna do my thumb in the pink again to match my accent nail. And now again, because I've already done this once, I now know to use a very, very thin coat of this and the rest of this stuff. When I first did it, I just kind of globbed it on. So this time I'm going to try to use a very thin coat. This time what I'm gonna do a little bit different is I'm just gonna try to kind of push this powder down a little bit on it, just to make sure that I am getting a good coating on there, because I do not want to dip it twice. And again, I want to make sure that I very thoroughly clean around it. I don't want to have to deal with these extra pieces here once I put the activator on it. So it's easier to get it off now. Especially if there is any underneath your nail, you especially want to pay attention to that. It gets very annoying and it clumps up underneath there, and it's very hard to file out. So I really like to make sure that I get underneath my nail clean enough. Now, just so that I don't accidentally knock this off or anything, I'm going to go right in with the activator this time. I'm not going to do it how I did it before and just do them one at a time. So I'm going to go in with the activator now. As you can see though, it does do a very thin coat, which is why I usually do two. But for today, that is okay. Right, so I'm going to continue to do the rest of my nails. Now I am doing a bit better and a more precise job this time around, because I do want to keep these ones for a while. The other ones I knew that I was just going to be taking off to show you guys the whole process, so that's why I'm taking a bit more care with these ones. Okay, so the dipping is done. That is one coat. I just have to put the top coat on and we are done. Ugh, and this is that top coat with the horrible lid that fell apart on me. Thankfully it's glued itself back together, it seems. And again, we just want to use a very small amount of this as well. A little bit definitely goes a long way with this kit. I really don't like this top coat that comes with it. Oh my god. It's terrible. Ugh, you either put too little or too much. There's no real way to control it. I don't like it at all. But it's what it came with, so that's what I'm going to use. It's just so goopy and messy no matter how you do it. So hard not to use too much. All right, so we are done again. Camera back here for a second. All right, so now the video is officially done. So this is them with one coat. As you can see, it's a little, it looks kind of see-through. I don't know if you can see that being kind of see-through nails, which is usually why I do two coats. I just feel like it looks, more painted, I guess. But if you did want a more natural nail look, this is definitely the way to go. When you do two coats, it gets very thick and it does tend to look a little bit more like acrylic nails. But they're very, very strong. They're not gonna break. I can't even bend them. Like, they're super, super strong once you put this stuff on, which is why I like to use this once my nails have grown out. When they're short, I'll just use regular polishes. But when they're growing out, I like to use these just to help kind of keep my tips on there and not have them break. My tips for beginners, definitely start with one coat. It's definitely easier to get off. You're gonna wanna practice a couple times. Maybe practice with one finger first, putting it on and removing it, and putting it on and removing it, just so you get the feel for it before you do all your fingers. Because you don't want to do them all and then get in a panic trying to get it off. So I would recommend maybe just trying it with one finger first and just figuring out how it works for you and how you can use it. I think that's it. Hopefully you find this video informative. I've showed you how to do the two coats. I've showed you a couple ways to take them off, and I've shown you what they look like with one coat. So hopefully this will help you to feel a little more comfortable if you've seen these dip kits and you want to try and get into them and use them. And yeah, if you found the video informative, or if there's anything else you'd like to know, if there's anything I didn't cover, if you have any questions or suggestions or comments, let me know in the box below. If you don't feel comfortable leaving in the box below, you can always DM me on one of my other social networks. I believe they're down in the box below. And yeah, so if you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you want to see more videos on any other products like this, let me know and I can definitely cover that. That's it. I hope you enjoyed the video and found it informative, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.